I recently posted a video where I showed you how the pros read what their opponents are going to hit next based on the grip, swing path, the balance that they have, and their body position. But there is one more other thing that I think warrants its own separate video. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can read when one of your ground strokes is doing a whole lot of damage and what you should be doing then, instead of allowing your opponent to reset the point. I notice a lot of times that players hit really great ground strokes, and especially newer players don't read how much pressure they're putting on their opponent with that ball. And then they're kind of surprised that a shorter, slower ball is coming back, and they're not really reaping the reward for their great shot. So in the best case scenario, they're allowing, in fact, their opponent to reset the point. They have to start over building the point. And in the worst case scenario, they're missing that kind of weaker shot outright. So what is it that we need to look at? So if we're just waiting to see where the ball is bouncing, by that time, it's too late because there is a little bit of a lag momentum where I'm judging all that. So I need to be looking at something before my opponent is actually hitting the ball. Your first big cue is when your opponent is stretched. And that can start right off when you're serving. So for instance, if you're hitting a slice serve wide, and you're seeing somebody stretched like that, there's no way on earth that I'm gonna produce a really powerful, well-placed return. So that is when I need to be crouching up. Or it can be right off your return. If you manage to hit a really, really aggressive return, especially off second serves, instead of recovering back to the middle, all the way behind the baseline there, although you're seeing that your opponent is hugely stretched, they're basically having to sprint to the ball, you want to move up with that. After you really did that damage and you see your opponent stretched, turning, sprinting to the ball, chances that they produce a really good high quality ball, very low. So what you're looking for is to move forward. Either you're getting a weaker, higher ball that you can then attack even more, put away, or you might even get an easy volley. And even if you feel that your volley is not that great, you don't have to hit a super duper volley. You've already put so much pressure on your opponent, they're somewhere out there in the fence. All you want to do is redirect the ball, punch it into the open court. Even if you were to miss that volley, that's okay. You're investing into future points because basically you're telling your opponent that they can't afford to just give you a ball back, kind of lollygagging into mid-court. So you're forcing them to hit more precise shots under pressure, and that is gonna force errors right there. Let's look at some real life examples from one of my clients that I did a match analysis for. And I think there were a couple of missed opportunities, but with experience and now exactly knowing what to look for, you're gonna win more points in the future.
Really good serve. The returner is basically, yep, outside the doubles alley here. And I don't care what kind of quality that next ball has, you have to come in with that. See here how he's on a full run? Don't allow him to set the ball back because he's hitting an okay shot, which now gives him problems here because it ends up being deep. But it was a nice high ball. That would have been, if you had been in here, a nice and easy volley that you could have just knocked off to the open courts. So one more missed opportunity here. Again, really good ball that sets it up, this one here. And you see how dynamically he has to push off to move to the ball. His first reaction is not to move forward, it's to move sideways. And also now one step back. And you'll also notice that he's switching into a continental grip, and his racket face is pointing this way. All of that means it's gonna be a really, really passive ball. So at the very latest, you now wanna be on your way forward. But again, this player missed this a little bit and now crouched in a little bit here, which is too late then because now you're being pushed back. And again, now the entire advantage is given up because that is not a good enough quality ball.
Another sign that you may be able to crouch forward to get into a really aggressive court position is when your ground stroke pushes an opponent away from the baseline. When their first reaction is to turn away from the court, basically like a ballroom dancing step, they're taking a step back and you're taking a step forward. So pushing them off the baseline, and then that giveaway is if they're making contact above their shoulder. That's not ever going to be a very controlled ball. So again, that's when you're crouching forward a little bit. And if they do end up hitting a higher and deeper defensive ball, it's defensive, it's slower. So you can still move back and then reset the point. But chances are that you're going to get a really juicy ball.
So this first point here, the returning player hits a really good return. It's deep, and you'll see the first reaction here is for the server. He's still inside the baseline and now basically has to immediately lunge to his right. And he's also being pushed back. So instead of coming back here to the middle and then regrouping from this position right here, when you're seeing that this player is as stretched and pushed back, you need to come in, because the next ball is something that he's not expecting here and basically has to hit a really awkward shot, giving up the entire advantage of the point.
If you missed the video that I talked about in the beginning, here it is. Do check it out.